Ganeto.
Hello, trainers! Ganeto here, with the first Nebula Cup that has been completed with success. I don't want to spoil the ending yet, and if you have no clue about what I am talking about, since this is not a Sylph Cup related content, check the video that is popping up right now! Okay, trainers, if you like this content, which is kinda different than usual, be sure to leave a like before you go in the end, or even subscribe to the channel. And don't forget, join OsMo PvP for more fun cup tournaments. Links for everything will be in the description. So, this themed cup was my idea all along, and as I make this introduction to you, you are having a closer look at my Pokémon and their movesets. All in all, Nebula Cup allows participation to Flying, Dark, Poison and Electric types. Yeah, you guessed that right, Electric Pokémon are supposed to be the meat and potatoes of Nebula Cup, and Flying typing is the quickest link, at least that's at a first look. However, my team has two Flyers, one of which can beat the Electrics, and Skarmory can go pretty well throughout the meta. Nidoqueen is my second anti-electric. My main electric is Alola Graveler, by the way the number one pick for this meta. Toxicroak is my fighter, since I do not own neither a Scrafty or an Obstagoon. Really, I would most likely need a Scrafty for this meta, but anyways. And finally, we have one of my favorite safe switches in the entire game, as long as you don't get across an Azumarill, and that is Sableye. Okay, trainers, now you know my team, you know the meta, I just hope that you do at least. Now sit back, take your snack by your side, prepare for a super fun tournament, and after all that, let's face my brother in the first round! Quick update everyone, my team is on your left while the opponent is always at your right. I can see that my Nidoqueen has fairly good matchups against this team, so I decided to lead with that and have Toxicroak and Alola Graveler at the back. So let's see how we do. Totally outplayed by that waterfall, well done my brother, and we're going for the switch here to finish off with the Volt switches, but this thing has charged up to a charge move, and that is really huge for my brother since they can actually bring out the Toxicroak and straight farm it down with the counters. Let's see how this will turn out. Going for the Thunderbolt, we will take the last shield, but yep, this match is already over for me. Anyways, you can see that my brother is no joke at all, and even though I underestimated him, he actually managed to win the first match, and let's see how the rest of them will turn out. We will get hit by that Mud Bomb, it will not knock out us, but the counters will definitely will. Trying to do a desperate switch to my Nidoqueen, yeah, things are not going very good. And we proceed to the next match. In this one I was like, okay, we don't have to bring out our Toxicroak, let's replace it with Skarmory. Leading again with our Nidoqueen, we have the lead, kinda the lead here. We have to take one Mud Bomb at some point, so I'm like, okay, bring it on. We can take the Mud Bomb, the counters will not hurt us, and then go for that Earth Power for a potential nuke down. Of course, my brother knows better, they are gonna shield and then bring out the Gyarados to waterfall me down, but I was expecting that move, going into my electric type to straight Volt switch down this Gyarados, but they unleash a crunch at the last moment. We have to block and then go for that Thunderbolt on the next Pokemon, which is the amazing Toxicroak. They have something in the back perhaps that our Skarmory can beat it with this, so we will bring out the Skarmory, straight farm down, and then go for the Sky Attack using the Dynamic Punch. And yes, trainers, the Dynamic Punch is the preferred moveset for the Toxicroak. Anyways, the last Pokemon is a Sifter, it is not an Umbreon or something like that, so just the Sky Attack will be enough to take it out. Almost take it out because I hit that great, but we win it anyways. And for the next one, I was very confused about what to use, so I decided to lead with my Skarmory this time. Perhaps we catch that Gyarados that really hurts us a lot, and then let's see how this will turn out, because that Umbreon is a painful Pokemon to have as your opponent. The foul plays are not gonna hurt a lot, we need about 3 or 4 to faint. Anyways, using our sky attack, we exchange about the same amount of damage to each other. We are gonna get hit by another foul play. This will bring us not very low, but at the point that another foul play will most probably take us out. Using that sky attack, if it lands, that will be huge. So we have one way to play this. We have to block this move and try to go straight for the farm down and have a lot of energy for whatever they have in the back. But I'm Ganeto and Ganeto knows better, so we're gonna go for the sky attack for no reason. I think that I should have been able to finish off with my fast moves. Anyways, the next Pokemon will be the Skarmory, and that is good for me. I have no problem with that. Not able to unleash a last second sky attack because we have that Alolan Graveler in the back, which is an absolute wall to the Flying Beast. Using the sky attack, not the Flash Cannon, and after that the Toxicroak will pop out, and we have the perfect Pokemon for that. And if you're thinking, how are you gonna lose this Ganeto, because you have the perfect matchups for those Pokemon. So yep, wait and see, things are not that easy. Using the Shadow Sneak, they are gonna shield, and after that I will try to go for the straight farm down with my Shadow Claws. A shield will pop up here, my last shield, they still have one, my brother still has one, and now we will go straight for that foul play immediately to take out the shield or just deal a nice amount of damage. We are dealing the nice amount of damage, we are gonna get farmed down with those fast moves, but we have the Alolan Graveler in the back. Nothing can go wrong, right, using the Rock Blast, and one more Rock Blast will be enough to finish it off. But guess what, trainers, overtap is a thing, so we're gonna lose this because my Graveler thought that a Volt Switch is a better move than the Rock Blast, and yeah, we're gonna take this loss on the first round. Doesn't matter though, it's my brother, I can deal with him later, so let's move on. For my next opponent and for my next round, I decided to lead off with my Skarmory since it has very good matchups against the entire team but the Magnezone. So I had in the back my Gliscor just in case this Pokemon decided to pop up, and have my Alolan Graveler there for that Mantine. The Mantine pops out right now, so we'll bring out our electric type, and one thing that I didn't know about Mantine is that it can actually threat the Alolan Graveler a lot if it lands that Bubble Beam. It deals a nice amount of damage, and with a debuff it actually doesn't take that much of a damage from those Volt Switches. And look, trainers, who decided to come into the battle for another time, and that's Nidoqueen. We can absolutely get farmed down at this point, but hopefully they decide to unleash a charge move. We will gladly take this charge move and then bring out our Grayscale to finish off the Nidoqueen without any shield usage. At least that's our plan. Let's see how this will come out, because we're having a lot of lag issues here. We connection popping out. We most probably have done more fast attacks than our opponent, and that really sucks for our opponent. So yeah, using that Earth Power, we can take it and then go for the Sand Tomb of the last Pokemon, which is the Beedrill. Let's see if they decide to block, and they do block, so our Skarmory can come into play and sweep the rest of the team. The Beedrill will fall to this Sky Attack, even if it wasn't debuffed. Anyways, the Nidoqueen will fall too, and we proceed to the next match for the second round. Now for this one, I was thinking, okay, we have to stick with the same team, but let's keep that Gliscor in the front, because I am expecting the Magnezone to pop up eventually as a lead, as it has fairly good matchups against a lot of key Pokemon from my team. Using the Sand Tomb against this Umbreon, and I'm like, oh, that has to be horrible for me. Using the Dark Pulse, and Dark Pulse deals more damage than the foul play, and I'm looking horrible at this point. We will go for another Sand Tomb and try to switch out. I think, yes, that's what we do, but it is another Dark Pulse, and at this point it will hit our Skarmory, which is fine in a way, but they have this horrible Pokemon, the Magnezone. I was expecting this one, but good for us, we have kept our Grayscale alive for this scenario. And look at this Pokemon, how useful it can be in this cup, because if I had one, I would most probably would have used that in the place of my Alolan Graveler. A Mirror Shot will come into our part, and at this point I'm like, okay, perhaps we can survive this move. It is a Mirror Shot, but it deals enough damage to bring us very low at the point that another Mirror Shot will faint us down, We have no other options than to block this move, and then the Mantine will pop out. And we have one shield less than our opponent. Things are not looking that hot right now using the Rock Blast. Let's see how our opponent will react. They are gonna shield, and that is very interesting because right now we have no option than to let this Bubble Beam go through and then straight farm down. But what I was telling you before, even if a Bubble Beam comes into our way, we can absolutely get destroyed by a Mantine, even though we have an amazing move to deal a super amount of damage against it. Anyways, our gray score is severely hurt. We wouldn't have won this match anyways, and we proceed to the last one. The winner takes the round. So yeah, we're having a horrible lead against the Confusion user with our Toxicroak, so we are bailing out to our Alola Graveler, and hopefully they do a very bad switch to the Mantine, most probably a misplay by their part. But this Mantine puts up quite the fight, and even though it is gold by electric types, in this scenario it can take out a shield, so you cannot say that it is entirely gold by electric types. Anyway, the next Pokemon is, I don't know what it is, but we will go for the Rock Blast. It is the Magnezone. I was expecting the Magnezone as always, so that's why I brought my Toxicroak in first place. And the Thunderbolt will hit the Magnezone for a nice neutral damage. Actually not neutral, it is not very effective. And we will bring out the Toxicroak. They will swap out immediately to the Venomoth. And at this point I'm like, okay, we have to go straight for those foul plays. And let's take out the Venomoth as fast as we can, because our Sableye is the key Pokemon here. The Backbuzz will come at our way, but we will block it. And another foul play will be more than enough to finish out this Confusioner. And the last Pokemon that they have is the Magnezone, which is already hurt, and they have to unleash a charge at some point. At this scenario it is a wild charge. We will faint, but Toxicroak will come into the battle countering down the Magnezone, and we're gonna take the first win of the Nebula Cup. Round 3 trainers, leading with Skarmory, which is only afraid of Alolan Raichu, Toxicroak as our safe switch, and Sableye as our key Pokemon. We both swap out after that bad lead. Normal things happening here, and we're gonna face a Gliscor. Straight Dynamic is our play, and we're gonna use a shield if we want to finish it down or provoke a shield by their part, which is always nice if you think about it, since we have the Skarmory in the back waiting to finish off the remaining HP from that Gliscor. Going straight for another Dynamic. Let's see if they shield at the last second before we faint down. They are shielding, which is good for us, no problem. We can bring out our Skarmory and straight farm down. We can take 2 Night Slash or 3, no problem for us. We know that the next Pokemon is going to be the Alolan Raichu, which is a very decent wall to any Skarmory out there, so we can actually take this Night Slash, finish off with fast moves, and go straight for that Sky Attack for any neutral damage that we can put out to this thing before they unleash a charge move by their own, using a shield, which is really huge for us. And now my Sableye can actually come into play and shield this Thunder Punch, face their last Pokemon, which is a Toxicroak. Let's see how this will end. It will be super close, I think, using the Shadow Sneak. Almost down goes the Toxicroak. We can absolutely take one charge move before fainting, even if it is a Mud Bomb or a Sludge Bomb as it is. We can absolutely take it, faint down the Toxicroak, and finish off the match with just one foul play against this Alolan Raichu. We're gonna take the first victory, and we're gonna proceed to the next one, the second match, in which I'm thinking about what to lead, because I'm pretty sure that the Dragonite will pop out eventually. So I'm like, okay, perhaps they're gonna lead with that, so let's bring out my boy, my Skarmory, which is the real MVP for this team, and let's hope that we will catch a Dragonite. And you saw that, yep, that was a snap of my fingers, and the Dragonite pops out. We're gonna resist every move that the Dragonite will throw at us, so no reason at all to shield, but it still does a nice amount of damage. Going for the Sky Attack against this Gliscor, no reason at all to switch out, not that early at least. And then we're gonna bring out our Grayscor, and we're gonna go straight for those Night Slashes. Our opponent will try and do the same, so we have nothing to worry about using the Night Slash, and then it is our turn to unleash the charge move. Let's see how this will turn out using the Night Slash, and the boost comes out, So our attack rose sharply, we can absolutely take this move and then go for another Night Slash at the next Pokemon, which is most probably the Dragonite, and it is using the Night Slash. I'm hoping that actually I am focusing on the fact that I can take it, and they do. The concentration, our yoga absolutely paid off in the end. So yeah, we're gonna go for our Skarmory here, hoping that we can take out a shield out of them, or just use our sky attack and they will take it. We're gonna shield this move, I guess, because the Thunder Punch will knock us out. Yes, we're gonna shield and then go straight for that sky attack. If they take it, we can bring out our Toxicroak and finish off the match with counters, and that is what is going to happen. We can absolutely shield once here and then finish off with counters. We have already won this round, trainers, as we are sitting at 2-0. And because the video is already a long one, we are gonna skip the third matches if they are not that impactful to the game. Okay, battlers, round 4 is up against Poké Epeat. I hope I said that correctly, and his team is weak to Skarmory, so if we can protect our Steel Bird from Lantern, everything is gonna be just fine. Leading with our Sableye is a very solid option, and we're facing this Lantern, which we can absolutely wreck down with a proper shielding, of course, and we can have our Skarmory face a grass type or two grass types if they decide to bring them into play. And that is quite what is happening right now, because they switched in their Sifftree, so I'm like, okay, let's bring out my Skarmory, we can absolutely wreck it down with those sky attacks. Another attack coming into our way, we have to be really curious about that. It is a foul play, I was thinking perhaps they are baiting us because they had the shield advantage there, and we hopefully get it to no HP, to 0 HP right on time before they unleash another charge move. They have one shield left, but yeah, we can absolutely take this thing out with straight fast moves, because they're trying to do the same. No charge move by their part coming at all. And the last Pokemon is the Tropius, which is really good for us. We can go ahead, use that sky attack. They're gonna shield and then have our poison guy, our poison girl actually, because it is a female. We can take the leaf blade and then go straight for that stone edge to finish off the Tropius. Almost finish off a couple of poison jabs in combination with the Shadow Claws from the Sableye will be enough to take out the Tropius, and we're gonna take the first victory. Now for the next one, I was thinking that perhaps they're gonna lead with Sifftree, which is a risk, or a Lantern, so I decided to go with my Toxicroak as our lead, but they read us at a perfect ratio there with the Sableye coming out, and we can go straight for the Dynamic, no reason at all to switch out because we have Pokemon that cannot take out the Sableye so easy. We don't have a Charmer, for example, like a Togekiss. So yeah, we're gonna shield this one and let's see how this will go. We're gonna switch out to our Sableye to finish off with Shadow Claws, but it was too early. They have enough energy to unleash before fading down, and that HP that they had is about 2 Shadow Claws, not 1, so it was not that close as it seems. Using my Foul Play on the next Pokemon, which is the Water Gunner. The Water Gunner Lantern, actually, not a spark version of it. So we have to block again here. Our Toxicroak now can take out the Sableye if we take out the Lantern. Let's see how this will turn out, because we have no shields left using my Mud Bomb. Hopefully they will not shield. They don't shield, which is really huge for us. The last Pokemon that they have is a Tropius. And at this point I'm like, okay, Ganeto, just don't screw that up. You have to go for those sky attacks and just care if they try to block one charge move with their Sableye to absorb it with some weird scenario. Anyways, let's see how this will turn out. They have two shields up, we have none. They just used one using the Aerial Ace. It is not very effective. We still are at 50% HP, over farming just a bit, just in case they decide to go for the Sableye. And using the sky attack here, another shield pops up. This is the last one. Now we need only one to feint down the Tropius, and we're gonna go for the switch. No, we're not gonna go for the switch. We're gonna go for the farm down and then finish off the Sableye with just one sky attack. And that's it against the semifinals. Now it is our turn to face Flubber the Wapski. I hope I spelled that correctly as well, because he's an amazing trainer and we're gonna face him at the final match. Okay, trainers, you can see for once more that our Skarmory is pretty much a very good Pokémon for this meta, as it has only one weakness in its team, and that is going to be the electric Pokémon. Using my Skarmory as a switch in, as my safe switch, because my Toxicroak has no chance against a weak attack Mantine. You know that, and we're gonna go for those Sky attacks. They are gonna unleash a nice beam beforehand, of course. It will deal a nice amount of damage, and we're gonna go for another Sky attack. At this point, I'm like, okay, not shielding, not even by an inch this move. It is most probably a bubble beam. We're gonna take it and then go for another Sky attack. This will put very low this Mantine at a point that even a bubble beam will not be enough to knock us out. As you can see here, our attack will be dropped, but we're gonna unleash another Sky attack, which put an end to the Mantine. And at this point, we are looking pretty dope because we have both the switch advantage and the lead advantage. The next Pokémon is the Honder, so our Sableye can come into play and just finish it off. And the last Pokémon is going to be the Scrafty, which is really huge for us. And as you can see, trainers, besides that bad lead, we actually turned out good, because our Toxicroak found a favorable matchup right behind that Mantine. So we're gonna take this Power Punch and then finish off with counters to face the last Pokémon, which is the Honder. We can absolutely wreck it down with double Mud Bombs. And yeah, that's pretty much a GG there. So we're gonna take this first victory and proceed to the next one. If we win it, trainers, we can actually take the first place in this tournament. Now for the next one, we're gonna go straight for the same team, because I'm pretty confident they're not gonna lead with that Mantine. So it is the Raichu, and it is a Charm Raichu. I did not expect that at all. I forgot that it is running Charm, which is a very good option for this cup, as Charmers are a key role to Nebula Cup. They are gonna bring out this Mantine, which is really interesting, as we can actually bring out our Skarmory. And at this point, we're gonna take the Ice Beam like before, gonna go straight for those Sky attacks, and let's bring it as low as we can before fading down. At this point, even with a Bubble Beam, we are like one Sky attack away from finishing down this Mantine. Using another one here, let's see how this will turn out. Of course, I decided to shield before because I didn't want to get hit by an Ice Beam and perhaps get fainted at some point. So I don't want to risk that at all, using my Toxicroak in a desperate way to keep my Skarmory alive, but that is not a very good move. And at this point, the Charmer will return. I have to go straight for that foul play and hope that it will hit, but it is not gonna hit that Pokémon. So we're gonna go straight for my Skarmory, gonna have to block this move. It is most probably a Thunder Punch, but it is just a Brick Break, another Brick Break coming towards us, and we're not looking that good at this point. Long story short, we're gonna lose this one, so let's start analyzing a bit our strategy for the final Nebula match. Sableye is a nice lead by our part, as long as it won't come across this Raichu. Skarmory is the perfect Pokémon for us, since we know that Raichu is a Charmer, and Toxicroak will be there to fill any remaining gaps. Speaking of Toxicroak, we can absolutely bring it into the fight to fight this Raichu, and they're gonna bring out the Mantine, so we can go straight for that Dynamic Punch, do as much damage as we can, and they decide to shield, which is very good news for our team, since now we actually have one more shield up, and our Toxicroak is gone for a good reason. Using my foul play here to the Mantine, it will deal a nice amount of damage to the bulky Salah Pokemon. So we have to take this move. It is a bubble beam, bring it on. And right now we're gonna block this move because we don't want to get fainted so easy. It is a nice beam, very good block there, and bring out our Skarmory to face the Raichu. This is a very tough choice, so I decide to block, and hopefully it is a wild charge. Let's see if we can actually farm it down right now, since it has its defense dropped. And we cannot farm it down, but guess what, trainers, this is gonna be a Brick Break, a last second Brick Break, not a wild charge. So we're still looking very good. Can we do this though? Can we? Going for the Sky attack against this Honder. They have, of course, a shield up. The Honder will get shielded, and another sky attack will come immediately to their part. So this is pretty much a GG for us. We can absolutely take this win with a Sableye and finish off the match with a Sableye. So yeah, GG's and well played to our final opponent. It's a 4-way tie, I know it, really worth it. And I just have to admit that I hate my brother so much. Also a huge thank you to OsMo PvP for letting me host Nebula Cup with BattleCourier86. Without OsMo and BattleCourier, I would never made Nebula Cup a thing. A big thank you as well to all the participants that showed up, as a bunch of them are subscribers of this exact channel. So trainers, be sure to subscribe if you already haven't and like this video before you go if you enjoyed its content. Stay safe everyone, and I'll see you all on the next one!